Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yesh Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 38th of November. India's Prime Minister Modi interacts with COVID-19 vaccine developers as cases top 9.4 million. Foreign donors impose stricter conditions on Afghan aid. And Sri Lankan prison riot leaves 8 inmates dead, over 50 injured. And now for all the details. As India aims to vaccinate its citizens against COVID-19 as soon as possible, citing the rise in its COVID-19 cases tally, Prime Minister Narendra Modi held a virtual meeting with scientists and discussed the potential of various platforms for COVID-19 vaccine development. India's COVID-19 cases on Monday topped 9.4 million.
At the time when the whole world is eagerly waiting for a solution against the coronavirus and India's cases tally has already crossed the 9.4 million mark, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday appreciated the efforts by scientists to come out with a vaccine solution to tackle the pandemic. PM Modi on Monday held a virtual meeting with teams from Genova Biopharmaceuticals Limited, Biologica E Limited and Dr. Reddy's Laboratories, who are involved in developing and manufacturing COVID-19 vaccines. The Prime Minister's office said Modi also asked the companies to share their suggestions regarding regulatory processes and spread awareness and information among general public in simple language.
शुरुआती जो दो तीन चार महीने हैं उसमें संभावना है कि वैक्सीन हम देश के लोगों के लिए उपलब्ध करा पाएंगे और जुलाई अगस्त तक लगभग 25 से 30 करोड़ लोगों को हम वैक्सीन देने की योजना हमारी है और उसके हिसाब से पूरी तैयारियां देश के अंदर चल रही हैं.
On Saturday, Prime Minister Modi had visited the Serum Institute of India in Pune as part of efforts to get a first-hand perspective of the preparations, challenges and roadmap in India's endeavour to vaccinate its citizens against COVID-19. He had also visited Zydus Biotech Park in Ahmedabad and Bharat Biotech facility in Hyderabad as part of his three-city visit to personally review the vaccine development and manufacturing process against COVID-19.
Indian Vice President Venkaiah Naidu chaired the 19th meeting of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization Council of Heads of Government hosted by India in virtual format on Monday. Addressing the meeting, Indian Vice President said that terrorism remained the biggest regional threat. It is for the first time that India is chairing a summit-level meeting of the SCO since it gained full membership of the organization in 2017.
Addressing a virtual meeting of the 19th SCO Shanghai Cooperation Organization Council of Heads of Government on Monday, Indian Vice President Venkaiah Naidu hit out at the countries which continue to use terrorism as an instrument of state policy, though he did not name Pakistan in his remarks. During the meeting, the Vice President stressed on the collective need to combat scourge of terrorism and said India condemns terrorism in all its manifestations and described terrorism as the most important challenge faced by the countries in the region.
The most important challenge faced by us in the region is terrorism, particularly cross-border terrorism. Terrorism is truly the enemy of humanity. It is a scourge we need to collectively combat. India condemns terrorism in all its manifestations. We remain concerned about threats emerging from ungoverned spaces and are particularly concerned about states that leverage terrorism as an instrument of state policy.
It is for the first time that India is chairing a summit-level meeting of the SCO since it gained full membership of organization in 2017. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his Pakistani counterpart Imran Khan did not take part in the virtual meeting.
In news from Afghanistan, the international community imposing stricter conditions on Afghanistan in exchange for continued aid has asked the Afghan government to brief them about programs it has undertaken in the past year and also its programs for the next year. This comes after the international community at the Afghanistan Conference 2020 in Geneva last week renewed their financial and political commitment to Afghanistan for another 4 years.
The Afghan government will need to brief the international community about programs that it had undertaken in the past year and also its programs for the next year in order to get aid from the donors in future, informed Nazir Kabiri, the CEO of Biruni Institute, a research organization in Kabul. The Afghan Finance Ministry has also informed that this time the international community has imposed more restricted conditions in exchange for aid. The international community at the Afghanistan Conference 2020 in Geneva earlier last week renewed their financial and political commitment to Afghanistan for another 4 years. 2020 Afghanistan Conference was the last pledging conference of the transformation decade, aiming to take Afghanistan towards self-reliance. This comes as Afghanistan is right now struggling for peace, as despite talks being underway between teams of the Taliban and the government in Doha, violence in the country remains unacceptably high.
Moving on, after nearly a decade of unlawful imprisonment by the Pakistan government, political activist Baba Jan was finally released on 9th of November 2017. Baba Jan's arrest had sparked a global controversy with protests in Gilgit-Baltistan for his immediate release. He was jailed for participating in protests seeking compensation for people of the Attabad disaster that wiped out hundreds of villages in Gilgit-Baltistan.
After a decade of unlawful imprisonment by Pakistani authorities, political activist Baba Jan was released on Friday following years of protests by people of Gilgit-Baltistan. Soon after, locals in Gilgit-Baltistan began celebrations. Baba Jan thanked people of Pakistan-administered Kashmir and right activists for holding protests for his release. Baba Jan, a prominent local activist and a member of Awami Workers Party, was serving a 90-year sentence on trumped-up charges.
अपनी जानिब से और अपने असीर साथियों की जानिब से गजर और गिलगित बल्तिस्तान के सारे अवाम पाकिस्तान के मेहनतकश इंसानी हकूक की तंजीमें उन सब का मैं शुक्रिया अदा करता हूं कि जिन लोगों ने हमारे साथ इस 10 साल के तवील अरसे में हमें नहीं भूला बल्कि हमारे लिए खड़े रहे हमारे लिए जिद्दत करते रहे हमारे लिए इन लोगों ने आवाज बुलंद की खतूत लिखे तो इस वजह से जिसकी वजह से पूरी आवाम बन गई गिलगित बल्तिस्तान की आज हमारी रहाई मुमकिन हो गई वरना हमारी रहाई मुमकिन नहीं थी.
He was serving life imprisonment along with two other youth activists from Hunza after being convicted by an anti-terrorism court over the mass demonstration against the government silence in Attabad incident that left thousands homeless. Reports suggest that Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan's government was forced to take the action after Pakistan was slammed and isolated by various international organizations at several platforms for human rights violations.
In news from Sri Lanka, at least 8 prisoners were killed and over 50 were injured from clashes at a prison in Sri Lanka's Gampaha city, officials said on Monday. Unrest had been growing in some of the Sri Lanka's prisons, with inmates staging protests against police in recent weeks as they demanded an increase in coronavirus testing and new isolation facilities for infected prisoners.
At least 8 prisoners were killed and over 50 were injured from clashes at a prison in Sri Lanka's Gampaha city, officials said on Monday as first responders rushed to the site in attempts to quell violence triggered by pandemic-related distress in the overcrowded prison. The latest clashes at Mahara prison, about 10 miles north of capital city Colombo, started on Sunday when some inmates protested against prisoners infected by the pandemic virus being transferred from other prisons to the same jail campus.
තුවාලෙ වෙච්ච ඒ වගේම මරණයට පත් වෙච්ච සියලු දෙනාම මේ විදිහට යාගේ මුද ශරීරය ඉවත් කරගැනීමත් ඒ වගේම තුවාලකරුවන් රෝහලකට ගිරීම අවශ්‍ය කර තියාමා කරන්තිනවා ඒ වගේම මහේස්ත්‍රාතුමා ගැඳවලා ඒ සම්බන්ධයෙන් පරීක්ෂණ කටයුතු ආරම්භ කර තිබා ජ්‍යෙෂ්ඨ පොලිස් අධිකාරීවරයෙක් කරතේ යනු දැන් සාමකාමී වාතාවරණයක් තියෙන්නේ
Unrest had been growing in some of Sri Lanka's prisons with inmates staging protests against police in recent weeks as they demanded an increase in coronavirus testing and new isolation facilities for infected prisoners. Sri Lanka had witnessed an upsurge in the coronavirus cases since last month and over-congested prisons across the country have reported thousands of fresh infections.
Muslims in Nepal's Pokhara town on Sunday organized a protest against atrocities on Uyghur Muslims in the Xinjiang province of China. The protesters raised voice against the demolition of thousands of mosques in Xinjiang and the treatment being meted out to them by the Chinese government. Protesting Muslims joined the international community in expressing their views on the gruesome human rights violations against Uyghur Muslims. For the last 6 years, millions of East Turkestan people, mostly Muslim faith, have been held in concentration camps, prisons and slave labor camps. People in the camps have described being subjected to forced political indoctrination and torture and say they have been prohibited from practicing their religion or speaking their language. However, China regularly denies such mistreatment and says the camps provide vocational training. Moving on, a normal routine in studios around the world, 27-year-old Soraya Shahidi's artwork in the conservative country breaks a tattoo taboo. Soraya believes she is the first female tattoo artist in Afghanistan, where some religious scholars say tattoos are forbidden under Islam. But she insists that her artwork is legitimate.
Soraya Shahidi is no regular tattoo artist. She is the first female tattoo artist in Afghanistan, a country where many still believe ink on skin is a sin against Islam. Shahidi acquired her skills while living as a refugee in Iran and Turkey, but has decided to return to Kabul to fill the void.
و میتونستم این کارو در خارج از کشور انجام بدم ولی خواستم این کارو در افغانستان انجام بدم چون که تاتو آرتیست خانم در افغانستان نیستش تنها نمیتونم بچهای کار انجام بدم ما خانم هم میتونیم
شاهیدی said interest in tattoos is growing among young people in the country with girls usually opting for more delicate designs such as flowers butterflies or names of their loved ones
علاقه زیادی به تاتو دارم و به خاطر همین آمدم پیش سرعی جان برای تاتو. تاتوی من به خط هندی است و به معنی شجاعت.
Apart from tattooing, Shahidi also provides eyelash extension and manicure services, all of which were banned during the Taliban tough rule. The Taliban have recently been projecting themselves as more moderate. At the same time, they have warned against the mingling of men and women and have denounced those they saw as encouraging women to defy Afghan customs.
Sikh devotees in India celebrated the 551st birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev, the founder of Sikhism, on Monday by visiting the holy shrine of Golden Temple, taking holy dips and lighting candles. The birth anniversary, called as Guru Purab, is considered as the most sacred day among the Sikh community.
Sikh devotees visited the holiest shrine of Sikhism, the Golden Temple, in India's northern Amritsar city on Monday to celebrate the 551st birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev, the founder of Sikhism. Devotees took holy dips, lit candles, and offered prayers early in the day to mark the birth anniversary.
इसलिए हम लोग आए हैं कि आज गुरु पर्व है इसलिए हम मत्था टेकने आए हैं बहुत अच्छे से दर्शन किए हम लोगों ने बहुत ही अच्छा लगा मन को बहुत शांति मिली बहुत ही तृप्त हुआ मन मेरा बहुत ही तृप्त हुआ मेरा मन
गुरु नानक देव द फर्स्ट सिख गुरु वाज बोर्न इन ननकाना साहेब ऑन द फुल मून डे इन 1469 इन द कार्तिक मंथ ऑफ द हिंदू कैलेंडर हिज बर्थडे इज सेलिब्रेटेड एज गुरु नानक जयंती
ਸਾਡੇ ਫਸਟ ਪਹਿਲੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ ਦਾ ਗੁਰਪੁਰਬ ਹੈ ਜੀ ਜਨਮ ਦਿਨ ਅਤੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਸੰਗਤਾਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੁੰਮ ਹੁੰਮ ਆ ਕੇ ਪਹੁੰਚੀਆਂ ਹੋਈਆਂ ਨੇ ਅਤੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਦੀਪਮਾਲਾ ਵੀ ਸਵੇਰੇ ਸਵੇਰੇ ਜਗਾ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਦੀ ਖੁਸ਼ੀਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪ੍ਰਾਪਤ ਕਰਦੇ ਨੇ ਸਾਰੇ ਸੰਗਤ ਇਸ਼ਨਾਨ ਕਰ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ
Meanwhile, devotees in Indian capital New Delhi also visited one of the most prominent Sikh Gurudwara or Sikh house of worship, Gurudwara Bangla Sahib, to offer special prayers on the occasion. Sikhism was founded in the 15th century in Punjab, an area straddling the border between Pakistan and India, by Guru Nanak Dev, and has had 10 successive gurus.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/isasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at isasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.